And this nonsense must now stop. This sense of entitlement that is being exhibited through the reckless remarks by Governor Mutahi Kasikahiga must now come to an end. The government of the Republic of Kenya cannot be a property of only those who voted for it. Because every Kenyan, regardless of where they voted, pays taxes. The people of Kakamega, the people of Bungoma, just like the people of Migori, the people of Siaya, and the people of Nyeri are taxpayers. And therefore, they are entitled to development just like any other person in this country. You cannot come out in the public as a leader who is elected. You cannot do that. You come out and start preaching politics of primitivity, politics of backwardness. We don't care the kind of war you have in Yahuda. Hiyo vita mko nayo ndani ya Uda ni yenu. Hiyo ni yenu. Hiyo vita ambayo iko ndani ya Uda saa hii ni yenu. Lakini msitumie hiyo vita kudharau Wakenya wengine. Si namna hiyo? Uwezi tumia vita ndani ya Uda kuanza kudharau Wakenya wengine ambao sio wana Uda. Kila Mkenya ako na haki ya kupata maendeleo. Kwa sababu kila Mkenya analipa ushuru. Ukianza kuongea vile unaongea, tukikwambia basi nyinyi mkae wenye walipigia serikali kura mtoe ushuru na wengine wakose kutoa ushuru, mtafika wapi? Somebody occupying a high position such as that of governor must be responsible with what he says in public. Must be extremely responsible and must be careful what comes out of his mouth in the public. Don't use the civil war in Uda. Don't use that civil war or that battle that is going on in Uda to start creating animosity in the country. There are so many Kenyans who are not bothered with what is happening in Uda, including these people of Siaya. Because they are not members, we don't know what you agreed upon as older members. We don't know what has caused these differences now. We don't know what you are fighting over. We don't know. And it is none of our business knowing. But you cannot ridicule other Kenyan communities on account of how they voted in the last elections. So that governor of Nyeri must be called to order. He must be called to order. The new vote can never be for top up. Never. Never. The new vote will remain and remain intact. It will remain intact. It will remain compact. Okay? It will remain indivisible. It will remain. The new vote that will make a difference in every election. And if there is anybody who is interested in engaging with the new community politically, there is only one route. And that route is Raila, Amolo, Odinga. Any other route is a waste of time. We are ready to engage with every other community. We have got no issue with any single community in this country. We are a friendly people and we are prepared and ready to continue engaging with all Kenyan communities and work with them together for the development of this country. And I want to say that the Honorable Musalia Mudavadi, the Honorable Musalia Mudavadi, recently we were at his office with Baba. When he was officially announcing the setting up of the campaign secretariat for Raila Odinga towards his AU bid. We want to say that we support that move. And therefore the campaign for Raila Odinga for the AUC chairmanship must now be run and managed professionally by the secretariat that has been formed or that is going to be set up jointly by Baba and the government of Kenya. Our position is clear. Very clear. And our party leader, the Right Honorable Raila Odinga, 2 days ago, issued a comprehensive statement on the Finance Bill 2024. And what he stated in that statement are the irreducible minimum. So we are waiting for the report of the Committee on Finance. The report of the Committee on Finance led by my good friend, the Honorable Kuria Kimani. If they come back to Parliament next week that they have listened to the cries of Kenyans and they have also listened to the demands of Raila Odinga and they have therefore removed those punitive taxes in the finance bill, we shall talk. But if they come back with these punitive tax recommendations still intact in that finance bill, we shall say a resounding no. No. And we shall vote no. And this time round, we want to appeal to even our colleagues from the Kenya Kwanza side. Those who have been speaking in funerals and claiming to oppose this finance bill. The hour of reckoning is coming. We want to see you in broad daylight in Parliament when the voting time comes. We want to see you voting with us.
I'm praying that when the time comes for voting, my good neighbor, David Ocheng, will vote with us. And many of the MPs who are in Kenya Kwanza side, the time to stand with Kenyans is now, not tomorrow. If for sure you stand with Kenyans, come out and vote with us on the finance bill. This idea of roadside declarations. There are so many projects that are being promised left, right, center without the requisite funding to see them through. That is the problem we have here. You know, even in this county, there are projects that were promised. Some indeed were initiated by the Uhuru Kenyatta government, including even this road of Gotnanga Barubiri. Yeah? This road of Gotnanga Barubiri. It was a Uhuru Kenyatta project. But can you imagine that in this financial year we are getting into, I think they have only allocated about 100 million shillings. Only 100 or so million shillings, which cannot even do more than 4 kilometers of tarmac. So the question is this. Why continue to overburden Kenyans with taxes on account of projects that you continue to promise Kenyans and yet you are unable to fund them? Just live within your means. Live within your means. So the Kenya Kwanza government must learn to live within its means.